In this Anvil video, we're going to be taking a look at all the classes, or breakers as they're called in the game. I want to show you guys all the skills and abilities of each one so that you can prioritize what to spend your crons on if you're playing the game, because they come kind of few and far between on the pass. And you don't want to buy one and find out that you don't like it, and there's no way to test drive these things before you play them. So in this video, I'm going to show you what they do and talk a little bit about each one. The first thing I want to mention is that there are essentially three archetypes in the game with four models for each archetype. So you're going to have light, medium, and heavy. The light obviously has the most mobility, has least armor, has least health, die the quickest. Then you have somewhere in the middle, which is medium, that's got more protection. The dodge is a bit smaller. They, you know, can take a few more hits. And then you have heavy, which doesn't have any sort of dodge at all, but has a block. They have the most health and most defense, and they're hardest to kill. The first breaker we're going to take a look at is jungler. This is one of the three default you begin the game with that you can play right off the bat, and it is a medium setup. Besides the medium dash that the jungler has, it also has explosive mines that you can put down that deal significant damage if enemies run into them. It has a bullet slash sort of animation that can clip a lot of enemies that's not super high damage, but can knock enemies back or interrupt their attacks. And it has a crossfire ability that basically clears the screen. This is sort of a defensive type breaker because of the fact that it has mines and it doesn't have like a lot of mobility like the lighter classes. So you kind of want to throw your mines down and stay behind them and fire, you know, well, and let enemies come to you. If you like playing defensively or you like playing at longer ranges, this is a great class. It synergizes very well with other breakers that have defensive abilities like shields, where you can stand inside them or behind them and fire away. Throw your mines down, let enemies come to you, and use bullet slash to knock projectiles out of the air. The next one we're going to take a look at is the Sandman medium breaker, and they have tornado grenade, sand sniper shot, power shield, and slow dash. The dash is very similar to the one that jungler has. Instead of getting a movement speed buff when you successfully pull it off, you instead get 100% crit chance for 5 seconds. So if you're playing a crit-focused build, this is not a bad breaker to choose. The tornado grenade is great when there's a lot of enemies on the screen or one difficult enemy, as it pulls the enemy in and doesn't let them go, so you can throw it, they get stuck in it, and you can just range it down without it dealing damage to you or being able to get into melee range. Sand Sniper Shot is an extremely high damage ability, kind of in a projectile in front of you, so it doesn't have like a wide radius. You can modify it to hit more area, but it's a very high damage shot, so it's good for dealing with difficult enemies or a big group of enemies. And Power Shield gives you a damage shield that blocks damage while also increasing your weapon damage. So you're probably going to want to use this in like more difficult fights or when there's a lot of enemies and you need to mow them down fast. Compared to the jungler, it's a little less defensive because you're not going to be putting down mines and like hanging out behind them. But it does have Power Shield and Tornado Grenade, which are both offensive abilities. So it leans a little bit more to the defensive side than perhaps some other classes do. The next one we're going to take a look at is Lightning. They have Shockwave, Homing Laser, Lightning Slide, and Quick Dash. Quick Dash actually gives you a shield if you successfully dodge enemy attacks compared to the movement speed or critical chance. So if you like damage shields on your dodge for this sort of class style, then this might be a good choice for you. Additionally, Shockwave is very, very high damage and very wide arc, but very short range. So it's easy to take out large groups of enemies, but it's less effective against one single target because it hits so wide. You're going to miss a single target with a lot of the damage potential for this ability. Homing Laser is a nice ability for not really having to aim. You can just move and fire this thing a few times, and a lot of homing lasers will go out and hit enemies even if you're on the move, even if you're not like looking directly at them. It's really good for getting out some damage while remaining mobile. Lightning Slide allows you to be extremely mobile by moving you very, very quickly across the screen, and you can control where you go while you deal damage to enemies around you in a small AoE. And it also increases your attack speed by 50% for 5 seconds after the skill ends. So you fire very, very quickly once this skill ends. So if you have a slow firing weapon or maybe a fast firing weapon, then this can help you out a lot. In terms of all the medium archetypes, Lightning has the most mobility. It's probably the most offensive of the ones available. So if you like being more mobile, but you like having the more health and defense of this archetype, this is a good choice for you. The last medium archetype is Liner. They have acceleration mode, which increases their attack speed temporarily. It makes them fire missiles more often. They also have a missile launcher that fires a lot of missiles in rapid succession. They have an electro trap, which is another defensive ability that puts a trap down that when enemies run through the beam, they take damage. And their dash increases their attack speed if they successfully dodge something by 30% for 10 seconds. So they can get very high attack speed between acceleration module and dash. Liner is probably my least favorite medium archetype. Acceleration mode doesn't feel like you feel it as much as you should, and it has a really long cooldown, so you don't get to use it all that often. Missile Launcher looks cool, and you can hit a lot of enemies with it, but it doesn't deal enough damage, in my opinion. Electro Trap is really strong. It's a really good defensive ability. It deals very, very high damage and doesn't let enemies through it very often, so it's good for a defensive playstyle. But I just feel like the overall performance of this archetype is not as good as maybe some of the other ones. Moving along to the first heavy archetype, you have Guillotine, who has Shield Charge, Executioner, Axe Summon, Guard Counterattack. This is, again, one of the default three that you can begin the game with, so you should be fairly familiar with him if you're playing the game already. His Shield Charge ability lets him charge forward with the shield out for about 3 or 4 seconds. That gives him some mobility. He really lacks mobility, so this is a really good ability to get him from point A to point B quickly, to get him out of harm's way, or to get him to enemies that are like ranging attacks at him so he can get in range. It's very hard to control, in my opinion, and it has very low damage, although you can boost that with upgrades. Executioner is absolutely devastating. It does a lot of damage. It hits in a large area. It's really good against multiple enemies to just AoE them down real quick. Axe Summon, long cooldown, huge area of effect, does excellent damage. Very good for clearing screens or just getting rid of a lot of small enemies. The Guard Counterattack ability is what the heavy archetypes are mainly known for. They can hold down, block, or guard, whatever. And they can basically reduce the damage they take or sometimes nullify it completely. And if they time it like a parry, when an attack lands on them, they do a counterattack that does devastating damage. And sometimes they get special effects if they time this perfectly, depending on what upgrades they have. Guillotine is a very, very tanky character. So if you like playing someone that's going to get up in the middle of everything, not die very easily, can take care of himself, this is a great class to play. It can be a little bit difficult to get used to melee in this game if you're not familiar with these sort of games, but it's not that hard. And there are some bosses that just don't seem like they're made for melee combat. So sometimes you'll get a bad roll on your world and get a boss that has like constant AoEs around him that can make it quite challenging. But otherwise, it's very, very fun to play. Next up, we have Mountain, which is another heavy archetype. It's got Recoil, Stun, Meteor Smash, Jump Shock, and Recovery Guard Counterattack. Its guard actually heals it while it holds block. So one really good thing about this class that makes it a little bit tankier than maybe some of the other heavy sets is it can actually heal itself while it's holding guard, which is fantastic. Recoil Stun is a great ability. It basically groups up enemies in front of you while you jump backwards, stuns them all, and then it detonates for a modest amount of damage. It's a very good crowd control ability, even though the damage isn't that good. Meteor Smash is an amazing ability that hits 3 times in a row that deals incredible damage, hits in a wide AoE area, moves you forward through enemies. Really fun to use and it's really good, but it does have a little bit of a long cooldown. Jump Shock is an ability that makes you jump 3 times, like forward and attack. You can change directions midair or, you know, in between attacks rather. So you can like jump one way, then the other way, then the other way if you want, if enemies are moving around. But the damage on it is actually quite low compared to basic attacks. So I feel like using this ability, unless you can get buffs for it that make it more interesting or more effective, is almost a waste. Overall, the survivability of Mountain is very, very high, but I feel like his damage is a little bit lower than some of the other heavy archetypes. Next up for the heavy archetypes is Rush. He has Lightning Flash, Sandbeam, Charge Rush, and Guard Counterattack. His Guard Counterattack is exactly like Guillotine's, so he doesn't heal, he holds guard like Mountain does. Lightning Flash lets you rush forward to enemies and deals incredible damage. It's a great gap closer. Again, heavies don't have like a dash or a dodge the way medium and light archetypes do. So having some mobility is really good. Rush is probably the most mobile of the heavy archetypes because all of his abilities make him move forward significantly and quickly. So if you like mobility in your heavy archetype, then this is probably a good class. Sandbeam is a frontal beam that shoots out like a short range in front of you, modestly short range, that deals damage over time to enemies while they stand in the beam and also petrifies enemies so they get stuck and they can't move. It's really good for like crowd controlling when there's a lot of enemies, but I find the damage on it is relatively low compared to some of the other abilities, so sometimes you're better off just killing things than petrifying. Charge Rush allows you to move forward very, very quickly, rapidly striking enemies. It's good for getting from one place to another or hitting one enemy very, very fast to deal incredible damage quickly. But what's really great about it is it heals you while you do it. So if you need healing, this class is very good at self-healing, making it have very, very good survivability. The last heavy archetype is Toast. He's the only one that actually begins with a ranged weapon. The other three all begin with melee weapons. So if you like playing a heavy preset, but you want to start with a ranged weapon, in this case a flamethrower, then this might be a good choice. His abilities are Energy Wave, Crash Wave, Singularity, and Shoulder Tackle. Shoulder Tackle works a little bit differently than Counterattack does, and he doesn't have a guard the way the other three classes, meaning like he can't hold guard down and take less damage in a pinch. However, his dash can do a sort of counterattack of sorts by creating a giant shockwave that deals significant damage, so you can still time the dash to do a counterattack. Energy Wall allows you to throw up a couple of walls that block long-range projectiles. It's like about a 120-degree arc, so it's not going to block all around you, but you know, you put it in front of you if you want to range from behind it, or your companions, party members want to range from behind it as well. It's not a bad ability to have, especially on bosses that shoot a lot of projectiles. Crash Wave is an amazing ability. You sort of jump up into the air and slam your weapon down, and then enemies in front of you get just absolutely blasted. They take burning damage. It's really good for like clearing the screen or killing some very hard to kill enemies. Black hole allows you to create a black hole in front of you that pulls enemies in, and while you attack, while this ability is out on the screen, you actually gain health. So if you need to gain health back, this is a great ability to use. Toast is probably the most defensive of the heavy archetypes because of the fact he has energy wall, because of the fact he has singularity that doesn't deal damage, it just pulls enemies into it. Allows you to sit back and range enemies down behind these while enemies are getting pulled into this stuff. So if you like playing a little bit more of a defensive heavy archetype, then this would be a good choice. Moving along to the light archetypes, the first one we have is Elsa. She's one of the default three that you can play with in the game, so you should again be somewhat familiar with her if you're already playing. Her abilities are Ice Wave, Ultra Beam, Beast Call, and Teleport. The light archetypes all have a teleport ability that allows them to move extremely far distances very, very quickly in the blink of an eye, making it like the best dodge out of all the archetypes in the game. And it's very good if you like mobile classes, so consider playing a light archetype if you like mobility. Ice Wave destroys projectiles around you in a 360-degree AoE, and it freezes all enemies. This is a really, really good ability when you're surrounded. Enemies are coming from all directions, and you don't know where to move. You just use this ability, and then you can gun enemies down and clear yourself out of path. It's very, very strong. Probably one of the best abilities in the game, in my opinion. Ultra Beam allows you to channel a short-range beam that does incredible damage. It puts you kind of in harm's way because of how short it is, though, so you have to be careful when you use it. It's usually good to use on enemies that are frozen because they can't fight back, or maybe the ones that are petrified from a party member. You can extend it with ability, you know, passives that you get throughout the game that make it longer, that make it more effective, and make you, you know, not put yourself in as much danger. But you have to be careful when you use this ability, but it's very, very high damage. The last ability is Beast Call, which summons like a giant beast that comes out of the ground, like a worm that distracts enemies and attacks them. It doesn't do very much damage, but it's really good at getting the attention of enemies, so it's not a bad ability to use on like bosses or hard to kill enemies, to throw it out so you can focus fire the boss down while it's focusing on your beast. The next light archetype is Uzi. This is probably my favorite breaker in the game. She not only has fast mobility with quick teleport, but she also has Frozen Shock, Phoenix Wings, and Umbrella. What I really like about her is she begins the game with assault hand pistols, which fire extremely fast even if at short ranges, but she's just constantly dashing around the screen because Phoenix Wings is essentially like another dash, but it's a dash attack ability combined, and it does very, very high damage, allowing you to clear screens with it if you time it right. Additionally, she has Frozen Shock, which allows you to freeze enemies, and you can make the AoE larger, so you can freeze a lot of enemies at once, and it works against bosses, so you can freeze bosses mid their attack animations and unload on them. Very, very strong ability. And lastly, she has Umbrella, which creates like a dome around her that blocks projectiles and keeps enemies out, or at least some of the weaker ones. And your companions or your party members, whatever, can get inside it as well and shoot from out, protecting you. And a lot of times you can upgrade it to heal you or make you do increased damage as well as your party members. And it's really great against bosses or enemies that shoot a lot of projectiles or if you needed to defend a position. So not only is she really aggressive with Phoenix Wings and quick teleport, getting in range, darting in and out of combat, but she can also be quite supportive by using the Umbrella ability. The next light archetype is Shuri. She has Gust of Wind, Sandstorm, Breeze, and Twister teleport. When she dodges, she actually leaves a small maelstrom behind that pulls enemies into it. So if you dodge from like with a lot of enemies around you or you teleport, they're going to get pulled into that and stuck. Shuri is probably one of the best, if not the best, support breaker in the game because Gust of Wind increases your attack speed, but also the attack speed of your allies and prevents them from being knocked back. A lot of enemies in the game knock you down and you got to get up, and sometimes you get down into like a chain knockdown situation. She also has Breeze, which puts a large AoE hot on the ground in a big area that heals anyone standing inside it. So she can not only heal you and your allies, but she can also buff your attack speed and the attack speed of others, making her really strong in a group, not so strong alone. Sandstorm also petrifies enemies that it goes through and like freezes them in place, ones that can be petrified anyway. It doesn't do much damage, so it's not like a great damaging ability, but it can help with crowd control. So again, Shuri is not a very high damage class, but she's very good at support by CCing and helping heal and, you know, make party members deal more damage. So she's best in co-op play, even though she's extremely resilient in single player, even if her damage is quite low. The last light archetype and the last breaker that we have is Bronte. She has Eye of Plasma, Detonate, Bionic Pulse, and Teleport. This is a rather hard breaker to play, in my opinion, because Eye of Plasma is a difficult ability to use, and Detonate detonates the Eye of Plasma. So Eye of Plasma shoots out this like ball projectile that pulls enemies into it and deals shock damage to them, and then you can use Detonate to blow it up and deal AoE damage to everything around where it ends. So it moves forward in a straight line, but you have like 2 or 3 seconds where you can't detonate it once you cast it. So like you can't hit something right in front of you. You need to be quite a bit away, and sometimes that's not always possible. Making it so that Eye of Plasma and Detonate sometimes are not available, or not, you know, you just can't use them because of the situation, which really only leaves you with Bionic Pulse and Teleport. Now, the problem with that is that Bionic Pulse actually removes all status ailments from allies and grants them damage to their skills, including yourself. So this doesn't deal damage to enemies either. It's a very good support ability, but you don't, if you can't use Eye of Plasma and Detonate because you have to constantly keep moving and you can't get away from the enemies that are up on you, like maybe you get knocked down and they keep jumping onto you, and you can't use Bionic Pulse to kill them and your other ability is Teleport, then you have really no way of dealing with enemies, which makes Bronte a better support class than, you know, a straight up DPS class, and one that's better played in a group than alone. If someone can tank for you and you can stay at range, then Eye of Plasma and Detonate are very, very strong, but if you're the one that's constantly being focus fired, you're going to have a difficult time. So that's it for our class guide or breakers guide in Anvil. I hope you guys are enjoying the game. I'm really, really digging it. I hope this gives you a better idea of which ones you should pick depending on what sort of playstyle you like, so that you can save your valuable crons and you don't pick something that you then regret and it's, you know, 5 more hours of gameplay before you can unlock the next one, or 10 more hours or however many more hours it is, and saves you a lot of time. How are you guys liking Anvil? What's your favorite breaker? Let us know in the comments below.